I'm half coat.
Hey, man.
Be busy.
What you doing tonight? You gonna go see a movie or something?
Well, Mr. Wall's holding a meeting tonight. Why don't you come?
Mr. Wall?
Yeah.
Mississippi gonna eat that French teacher alive.
Well, you wanna see me tonight, that's where I be.
Register, you have to go down to the courthouse and take a test, a literacy test. Now, we're going to give you a copy of this test and ask some of our students to
go through it with you so you can see how to do it.
But make sure you fill it out without spelling stuff wrong or scratching nothing out.
Because that's one of the ways they try to flunk you. So take your time.
Now, when you get to the end, here's where they try to trick you up. You have to interpret any part of the state constitution
to the satisfaction of the register.
Oh, no. People get killed trying to do this, son. And I ain't ashamed to tell you. It scares me.
That's how they want you to feel. But if you want to go try, we'll go with you. At the end of the class, we'll ask folks to let us know when they feel they're ready to go down to register. If anybody says yes, want to come with us?
Maybe.
It's up to you.
Man, I don't get it.
What don't you get?
It's up to you. Let us know when you're ready. What kind of leader are you?
I'm not any kind of leader.
What were you doing up there?
Just looking, that's all.
Then you let that be all. I don't want you going up there no more.
Why?
I don't want you getting hurt, that's why.
Well, they're not doing demonstrations, they're just registering to vote.
Same difference. You stay away.
What you so afraid of?
I'm afraid of your hot head writing a check that the rest of you ain't prepared to cash. I'm afraid of what you don't know.
How you know what I don't know?
Because you got my blood in you. You may be dreaming my dreams, but you ain't learned what I learned.
Daddy, why not let me learn it on my own?
Why not let me save you the trouble? Stay out of that place.
Next morning, three of the people from the first night's class went down to the counter to try to register.
You want to do what?
They like to register to vote.
What? Speak up, boy.
They'd like to register to vote.
Niggas don't vote.
They like to take the test.
All three passed the test. So the next day, five more people went down to try. And four of them passed.
In order to vote, you have to be registered.
Word spread fast.
Register.
And that night, 10 more people volunteered to take the test. But word also spread throughout the white community. And this time, they were ready.
Now for the final part of the test. How many bubbles in a bar of soap?
I don't understand.
Anybody know how many bubbles in a bar of soap? Well, you all flunked then. Now leave us be. We got real work to do.
Excuse me, but if you'd be so kind as to tell me how many bubbles there are in a bar of soap, then maybe I won't appear so ignorant the next time a body asks me.
Get him out of here.
All right, now. Y'all move on along. Go on. Yeah.
I'm going under the speed limit.
I don't get it.
Just looking for an excuse.
No, I mean, I don't get why you even here. I mean, you ain't from here. Your people ain't from here. Now you got the police climbing up your tailpipe, and it ain't even your fight.
One day last year, I was home reading the paper. And I saw this picture of the first sit-in students in North Carolina. And there was something about their faces. I kept staring at it. Staring at it. Till I figured it out. They looked like I felt.
Your mama know you're doing this?
My mother died 2 years ago.
Oh, I'm sorry. How about your daddy? So I can't talk to mine about this stuff.
Never known my father.
Give me a license. You're the nigger teaching the other niggers how to vote, ain't you? What are you doing?
Taking on your badge number.
I'd like to make a phone call.
I have the right to make a phone call. I was told to call you in case I got in some kind of trouble. I was just arrested in violation of the 1957 Civil Rights Act. Uh-huh. He said to tell you the FBI is going to investigate. The officer who arrested me is Officer Gray, and the sergeant is... Excuse me, what's your name?
Give me that.
Who the hell is this?
My name is Peter Crowley. I'm Assistant Attorney General for Civil Rights at the Justice Department in Washington. Who's this?
I tell you what. This has just been some kind of misunderstanding. Why don't you just pay a $5 fine and you can go free, all right?
I don't think it's fair I should pay anything.
I don't think you understand what I'm saying.
I understand what you're saying.
Oh, well, I'm giving you the chance not to go to jail.
I didn't break the law.
$5?
He broke the law.
And you go free.
I think I should go free for free.
Are you going to pay the fine or not?
No.
First thing he did, he went on a hunger strike.
You gotta see this.
You don't have to pull on me.
You gotta see this. All right, as soon as someone gets the phone number to the butcher shop, please give it to me. I'm typing up our phone list.
Nick. Hey, Archie, where my stand?
Hey, you stand at my shelter. We can squeeze in a few more.
She got a phone number?
No phone there. Here's what you gotta do.
People, listen up to Roland.
You stand at my shelter.
People. Come on now, I respect the speaker.
For those of you staying at Ma Sugar's house, she does not have a telephone. But
There is one at the butcher shop right down the street. We can use that.
I need that phone number rolling.
Hey, do we get meals where we stay?
Good question.
Excuse me, Mr. Chairman. Have you thought about how we are going to eat?
Yeah, well, I certainly thought about how I'm going to eat. This here's Mr. T-Bone and Nick. He got his cup.
All right, y'all. Mrs.
Colton's Coles and Nook will feed you. As will Chicken Charlie's, who has supplied these greasy bags of chicken to welcome you. Food is good, y'all, but it ain't free.
Well, we'll pay up soon as Tyrone here raises the money.
All right, now, y'all just remember to sign in when you eat, so to keep a tab, you understand?
Hey, it's a hunger strike. Somebody get this man some barbecue.
No, that's okay. I'll get something later.
I thought you was refusing bail.
And AA posted my bond.
That was nice of him.
I didn't ask him to.
Stick with us, my brother. You will get another opportunity.
Actually, I'm going to start working in the backwoods areas. Young people here can cover the city.
Damn. What you going out there for?
Some folks out there asked me to.
Deep clan country, my brother. They kill people.
Wow. Wouldn't be right not to go just because it's dangerous. I mean, we're asking people to take risks when they register. Anybody needs me, I'll be staying at Jonas Summers' house. Need some more practice farms.
Sure you want to do this? Reading the ass. Out these parts, ain't been but one Negro voter since Reconstruction. We can't find him.
He's just a black foul-smelling nigga straight out the cotton patch. And when this sitting stuff is all over, you'll still be a dumb, black, stinking nigga. You understand me, boy? Huh? You understand me? You want to get served? I'll serve you. You ain't what we eat? You like that stuff?
I do believe this be a porch monkey. You a porch monkey, little nigga? Sitting up on the porch, scratching your ass.
Scrawny little nigga, look at you.
Sound like a Jew heart.
Look at you. Yeah.
Sweet as you want to
be. Look at that. Look at that.
Yeah. Oh, you laughing now. You happy as a nigga in a watermelon patch, ain't you?
You want
to
laugh?
You ain't supposed to be eating off this counter. You supposed to be eating off the floor like the rest of your bunch.
We got us a light-skinned nigga. You still a nigga, you just apple pie colored, nigga. Get off my stool, boy. Don't you get back on that stool. Out my coffee shop, boy!
And you messing up the order of things around here. You remember, God is white.
This place for white people. No. White people. Look at here, we got us a vanilla nigga. How about a little more? Waste of good milk, piss a cow off.
Oh, you wanna wipe something off? Huh? Here, wipe this. Calm down. It's all right. You put your body on the line. That's what counts. You okay? It's all right. You spit it on me. That's gonna happen, big man.
Look, it's all right. If someone spits at you, you stay calm and say, may I please borrow your handkerchief?
No, I'd rather fight back.
You are fighting back. You're doing it your way, not theirs.
People, listen. If they knock you down, Tyrone, get down there. If they knock you down, you stay down. Curl up in a tight ball. Protect your vital parts.
Now, if someone is being beaten, you can protect him. Do not go for the attacker. You go for the victim. Absorb the blows. And then you get right back up on that stool. You keep it going. You don't let their violence turn you around.
Okay. Now, that's enough for today.
All right. Let's try it again.
No way. You ain't ready.
Yeah, I am.
Oh. You a tough guy, huh?
Yeah.
But you're not tough enough to be nonviolent. People, if you fight back using your fists like this fool, they will beat you until you die. But if you can refrain from responding with violence, after a while they will not be able to continue.
What if the guy's crazy and won't stop?
Then I will rise at your funeral and say, damn, he was nonviolent. All right. Tonight's homework, I want you to think about this. If not me, who? If not now, when? I'll see y'all tomorrow.
Hey. Where y'all going? You and SNCC now. Don't you never leave quiet. Woke up this morning with my mind.
It was
stayed on freedom.
Woke up this morning with my mind.
My mind, it was
stayed on freedom.
Woke up this morning with my mind.
My mind, it was
stayed on freedom.
The SNCC workers took us under their wings like they were our older brothers and sisters, which of course they were.
Welcome to SNCC.